Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our commander playthrough. I just tried to move a bit further with scanning something and we got Avatar Project progress almost immediately. So I am wondering if we actually need to do the radio tower mission right now. I'm just gonna try again. There we go, because that was what I wanted to complete. The null lands ability for Yessie, so that would be nice. I'm just gonna continue her training and then go for Solace. We don't really need to do anything else, so let's get back to the bridge and we're just gonna start the Advent Radio Tower mission then. Here we go. And I think that locks us into the end game, if I'm not mistaken. But again, as I said before, this is actually the first time I tried this. And I'm wondering if this is the end game, why there are so few enemies. 9 enemies. I can spend some available intel. Squad will start the mission with squad concealment. I think I'm going to take that. And I'm going to take squad targeting. So increasing the aim by 15 and the crit chance by 25. The rest is not really that interesting, so let's launch.
Commander, once we move on the Advent Network Tower, it's all or nothing. We won't have time to advance our research or deal with the wounded. We should only deploy once we're fully prepared.
Okay, fair enough. So that kind of confirms it. XCOM is prepared to make their final attack. However, once this mission is launched, there's no going back. All progress on research, engineering, and training projects will stop. Are you ready to assault the Advent Network Tower? I think we are. I'm gonna keep the save file just in case we need to do anything else, but yeah, here we go.
Setting course for Mexico.
Setting course for Mexico. Have we ever been to Mexico? I don't think we have. Because yeah, that's on one of the continents we haven't contacted yet. Interesting.
We're going to infiltrate the Advent Network Tower. We'll have to use a smaller squad. Try to draw less attention to ourselves than we already do.
I kind of also have the feeling that the squad we're going in with might actually be gone. That we're going to lose it if we go with a squad like this. So I'm going to go with a sort of an all-round squad. So let's get Jazz in for, since it looks like we're going to be dealing with a few lower level enemies, so Jazz's sword attacks might be very handy in that case. Geralt with the shred store might actually be interesting, but I'm gonna change his proximity mine with something else. Preferably normal plasma grenades then, just for the shredding might be good. Yes, and then not gonna go with Yang. And I'm just instead gonna go for, might actually just go for Benito as our hacker. Just to give us a bit of a variety in squad makeup. And yeah, that's gonna be our squad. So Operation Wolf Dance, secure the Advent Network Tower. Here we go. Jazz, Geralt, and Benito. 2 experienced soldiers and 1 that has a bit less experience.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Squad green to deploy.
Commander, it's time we put Advent down for the count. This'll be a 2-pronged assault. First, we hack the heart of the Advent Tower and disrupt their network before the speaker finishes his latest broadcast. Shen's cooking up a little surprise for them that should more than get their attention. With Advent in an uproar, we'll access the portal and take the fight to their front door. All goes well, they won't even see us coming. It's risky, but it's the best shot we'll get. Once we start this, there's no turning back.
There we go, a 2-pronged assault. So first, we're gonna attack the broadcast control center, hack everything there, and transmit evidence of alien atrocities. Here we go. So I've never played this map, and the interesting thing is as well, I think this is a pretty small map because it loaded in rather quickly.
Locate the access point and hack in to seize the broadcast signals.
And it looks like we're right on top of a tower here. Well, obvious because it's a wow. Yeah, this is pretty high. I'm gonna start moving up and I'll see you guys when anything happens. I think we spotted something. There we go, a single Archon. Okay then. In the corner of that room. This map is really interesting because there's two ways to go. But as you can see, the way right in front of where you spawn is blocked off by windows. So that would immediately destroy our concealment. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna try and move a bit closer with everybody. For example, Jazz over there. Benito on Jazz's position, and then Geralt might actually be at the entrance of this room here. There we go. Is that Archon gonna move? I don't think he is. Which is interesting to say the least. Because I might want to just bust in there and just scare him enough that he moves out of the way. Although there might of course be other enemies nearby, although I don't really see them. So let's open up the door. That doesn't alert the Archon. But what happens if I go inside now? Maybe I should just fire away. No, let's just go inside and see what happens. So I'm gonna break concealment like this. Might have been a waste of concealment then, but I'm wondering how he saw us, because he just turned a rogue. Okay, there's a Muton on top of the building. Did he spot us as well? Yeah, okay. No biggie, no biggie. We have plasma grenades. And that can easily take out both of them. No, why the hell would you go on the roof? Let's do this. Should shred the Muton's armor. And reduce the Archon's health by a significant amount. There we go. And now we need to spread this pretty well. Because of course... I only have so many attacks, so I could probably slash the hell out of the Muton, because that wouldn't miss. 7 to 9, so he only has 7 health left, which is good. And that seems to be only... No, it will end the turn, which is interesting. So let's go with Reaper. Then we go with a melee attack on the Muton. Preferably from this angle. There we go. So that definitely doesn't miss. Now we need to move Benito closer and see what his shots are. If his shots are pretty good, 89. Should actually try that, because he boosts the aim on every consecutive shot afterwards. There we go. And that gave Jazz another opening to just... I think I'm just going to melee him, because yeah, that's 100%. And does 6 to 8 damage now, because it reduces every time we use Reaper. And 6 damage should kill it. So there we go. There we go, down. So that's 2 enemies down. This is harder with only 3 squad mates. Just gonna put him in cover again. 2 out of 9 down. I'm just gonna have to be careful now how I proceed over here. Because that Archon was clearly put there as bait, so you would have to deal with the Muton as well. Let's put everybody behind cover, closer to where we need to go. There we go, maybe over there. Nope, okay, we spotted something. Oh, 2 Archons. That might be an issue. Okay. I could start this off. Well, not really starting this off, but go ahead with a rupture shot on one of them. Or we have the plasma blast, but that just targets one enemy, so I'm gonna go for rupture. And then try and kill one of these Archons here. Probably the one on the right. 70%. Oh, that was a hit and a critical. That was really good. So So that almost killed him, actually. So that's the effect of the squad aim bonuses. I'm wondering, will the Shredstorm cannon reach over there? It will, but I need to be careful that I don't hit anybody along the way. But it looks like it hits. So there we go. That kills one. Wait, what? Oh no. For some reason that didn't kill the one Archon over there. Shit, so I'm gonna have to fire at him. Oh, would've... Okay, never mind. Just thought I should use combat protocol for that. But yeah, that's the last of our turn and we wasted our Shredstorm cannon, which is really bad. Okay, what's he gonna do? Is he firing? He's getting closer. And it seems like he's gonna do blazing pinions, which isn't all that bad. It gives him a huge height advantage. But that's pretty much it. So if I move everybody around to the other side here. Jazz preferably over here. Don't think that should trigger anything else. Ooh. And I can't even move forward with Benito if I want to put him in cover. Let's just see. I'm wondering if Blazing Pinions just stops if you fire at the Archon. Or kill it, of course. So Geralt, move up.
Moving to position.
Jazz, fire away at the Archon. Not that I think you're going to kill it, but... Oh, it hit anyway. 4 damage. It was a dodge, probably. Yeah. That doesn't show us the text, but it looks like it was a dodge. And he's out of ammo already. Okay, so Benito, move back a bit. Then Geralt. Damn, this is gonna be close. It did hit, and it's a critical. 14 damage. Does that mean we have enough with a combat protocol to kill it? Yeah, we have. Just gonna do that then. Combat protocol. Goodbye, Archon. So that should stop its blazing pinions as well. Blammo, right out of the sky. And there we go. Does that stop the blazing pinions? It does not, of course, logically. Because those are explosives, obviously, and we don't really get the opportunity to get back from that. So let's move everybody up. That hasn't moved up yet.
I'm on it.
Reload Jazz, because he really, really needs it. There we go. I'm going to put him on Overwatch. I'm going to put everybody on Overwatch, actually. Yeah, there we go.
Moving Overwatch. Fire's getting close here.
Okay, I don't think the enemies on this map will move on their own, so let's move Benito up to the door. And I guess I'll see you guys in a second.
That's one of their transmitters. They didn't put a whole lot of effort into disguising the alien tech involved.
The design may be a function of the network itself. The amount of psionic energy filtered through that system is beyond measure.
So there's 2 Archons over there. Did they spot us? Yeah, they did. God damn it. So we defeated 4 out of the 9 enemies. So that means... I'm gonna have to be really careful here. I'm gonna use an incendiary bomb. I should get that through here somehow. How the hell did you even spot us then? Ah, this might be a problem. Provides high cover where you stand. I'm gonna do that. Just gonna put him on Overwatch, and then of course Jazz on Overwatch as well. Just gonna have to wait this out. So 2 attackers inbound. There we go, critical hit from Benito, and then maybe he doesn't get spotted. Maybe he does now. No. So blazing pinions inside of the building. Not really sure how that even works. Doesn't that just Add them on the roof? Yeah, it does. And nobody else attacked. Which is interesting. And I wonder if they didn't attack because of the shield wall ability. Interesting. Because now the only problem we have is that the other Archon is on top of the building. So if I move Benito over here, so that should be outside of the range of the blazing pinions. And then just fire at the Archon. You should kill it. There we go. Even with the... Oh no, that was normal damage. So there we go. And that should allow Jazz to freely move around again. But first, I'm going to send Geralt through the door. Into cover immediately. That should cancel his shield wall. Yeah, there we go. And now we can actually fire at the Archon, who is actually invisible at the moment. And what happens to invisible things? We miss invisible things. Obviously.
Adjusting sights.
Okay. I don't know what's happening. So Jazz is still concealed. Which is interesting to say the least. So let's put him right next to the door. Put him on Overwatch and see what happens. Because they're gonna go for... he's gonna go for Geralt. That didn't damage any of us because we were inside of a building. Spotted flanked enemy, okay. So that means he can fire at it, right? Yeah, there we go. In the face. Just 9 damage, sadly. And then, of course, he's pretty close to do a melee attack. Which is probably what he's going to do. Oh, that freaking didn't do much. Because Benito just freaking dodged that. That was awesome. Okay, so now just, 100%. Goodbye. 6 out of 9. Bring it on, aliens. We're equipped to take you all out. So let's put Benito into cover over here. Just reload Geralt. Might be a good idea. And then just put him on Overwatch. And put Benito on Overwatch as well. There we go. Let's put Jazz a bit further. If you're wondering, I reconcealed Jazz in between the turns there, but that was kind of obvious, probably. There we go, and then put everybody back on Overwatch, because this is... They're really spacing out the enemies in this mission, which is, of course, in our advantage, but we need to eventually get over... There is a bridge here. I'm wondering, can I hack something here? No. How the hell would you open that bridge? Do you just activate it then? It doesn't really help me to split up. Because I don't really want to split up.
Vado.
Nope. Maybe inside of the building here.
On your order.
Nothing yet.
Okay, problem.
That's gonna be another... What is your autoloader like, actually? A normal autoloader, so that means... If I reload now, you're just gonna end your turn, probably. Yeah, there we go. Should have reloaded Jazz as well, but... Gonna do that right now and then do another round of Overwatch, because we don't really have a timer here. Which means I can do whatever the fuck I want to do. Everything is breaking down around me, but... That's not really my problem, is it? That's more Advent's problem. Let's get inside of the building. Make a bit of noise. Because if I can lure the enemies towards us, that would be amazing. But they might be... They're not even doing anything. There should be 3 more enemies, but... I'm guessing they're all inside the building. Which we can handle, because we still have a few grenades. And supplemented with that is another mimic beacon we can use. Just in case. Okay then. Just gonna open up the door here. Still nothing. Are they gonna spawn in those last 3 enemies or what the hell is going on? Do I send somebody up top? I'm not gonna do that immediately. Just gonna put Geralt inside of the building. Seems like there's only one way in. Oh no, there's 2 ways in. Right next to this door. No, no. There we go. Then we're gonna open up the door. So the reason... This is interesting. So the reason why the Shadow Chamber didn't tell us about all the enemies... What? Did you just miss your Bladestorm? That is annoying. Didn't tell us about all the enemies is because there are only Mutons and Archons on this map. Which is interesting. Okay then, I think we have a few things we can do here, but... Because the Archon and the Muton are on a perfect line for the Plasma Blaster. But on the other hand, they're of course also annoyingly close to each other for... Lost my train of thought there for a second. Just wanted to say that I want to use the Mimic Beacon, but I don't want to lose Jazz's action to use that Mimic Beacon, so... Annoying, but... Firebolt. I think this is the most sensible thing to do, just blow up a part of the building with two guys inside of the radius. That should allow us to see who we can take out with Benito's shot. I think we're gonna go for the Muton, obviously. He has a nice shot on the Archon, but the Muton is pretty much dead if we fire at him, so... Or... No, we don't have capacity to discharge with him. But 6 damage is enough with the combat protocol. Which is interesting, because I do want to kill that Muton, of course. And 72 isn't all that great, so it's combat protocol on the Muton. And now we have the Mimic Beacon to draw the attention of the two Archons, which is good as well. There we go. We do need to put that Mimic Beacon somewhere that the Muton can see him as well. So if I'm not mistaken, we should be able to put a Mimic Beacon over here. And that should maybe just straight in the middle. I don't give a one fuck, because these should be the last two enemies. Unless we're fucked, of course, and they spawn in more enemies. But for now, these should be the only two. So... Is that another Bladestorm attack? No? He's not in melee range? Okay then. He's not even attacking, is he? Yeah, he is. Okay. Melee! 8 damage. Wow. Not enough to kill the Mimic Beacon, but that was hefty. And then another Bladestorm, because he passes Jazz. Blammo, and that was a hit. Okay, that's great. Because he's actually burning, which means the next turn he's probably gonna die. Just because of the burning effect. But since they're in a straight line, I might as well just finish it the way I wanted to finish it a minute ago. Just gonna move Benito out of the way. Put Jazz in his position. Pretty much. Just outside of the building again. And then use the Plasma Blaster to shoot these guys to another dimension. Yeah, something like this. Good. I might actually not kill the Archon in one hit. Okay, never mind, I did it. 16 and 13. Holy shit. Loot destroyed. How did that even get destroyed? Not that I care, but... Okay, this is the thing that we need to hack. So I'm going to move Geralt inside of here. And just put Benito on Overwatch, because I don't know what's going to happen now, of course. Again, I haven't played this mission before, so I don't know what can... and will happen. I'm gonna use Benito to hack that thing, of course. There we go. Put Geralt a bit further inside of the room. And just put both of them on Overwatch while Benito hacks the workstation. That was not Italian, I think, access point. System override! Recover a mission lead on an alien facility or adventure scanning times reduced by 50% for 4 weeks. Well, I think the game is almost over, so I'm just... Yeah, none of this actually matters, but... Yeah, thank you. I do want to destroy Advent and not just have a lead on an alien facility.
Solid intro.
There we go.
Status confirmed. We have control of the network tower. The signal is going out.
Okay then, and now what? That was it? And I apparently took 22 turns, I'm sorry for that. But, excellent then, I suppose. Oh yeah, maybe not that excellent. Something's happening. Now turn to yellow, which is probably... Oh shit! What is happening? Did everything
Firebrand
just
has cleared the perimeter,
shut
sir,
down?
Meeting limited resistance.
Well done, Doctor.
Yes, it would appear the feedback pulse is having the intended effect.
Shen, status.
So did every trooper and mech turned off?
Advent assures us this breakthrough will be available to all citizens immediately.
Oh shit, they're still broadcasting though.
Fellow citizens, for 20 years we have put our trust in Advent. In the elders, because we believed a better future is possible for all. Today, that trust, that belief, has been rewarded.
Oh,
that
was nice.
World, carrying the greatest gift from the elder. A revolutionary gene therapy, yes, but so much more.
Oh wow, and that's gonna change into black side. Yeah,
disease,
that was awesome.
To decay, to pain.
That was awesome.
A new tomorrow available to all of us today. Truly, humanity.
Dude, I would turn around if I were you.
Amongst the stars.
Okay, I think people are gonna be mad. Goodbye, speaker. And that's a successful mission music, so that was actually really well done.
I'm glad
the transition between the
success in the field is good for the entire crew's morale.
Oh shit. We wouldn't have any time for wounded, so that might actually mean that Benito can't go on the final mission. Whew. Facility lead, 3 Muton corpses and 6 Archon corpses, all taken care of easily. Recently uncovered information that could lead us to the location of one of Advent's remote facilities. No, thank you. Wait. Now what? Complete the Alien Fortress mission. That's just the only thing in my objective right now. So if I go to the bridge, do I actually have all the options now? I probably don't even have that. Holy shit!
Once and for all.
Okay then. 31 enemies. Holy shit. Heavy mech, sectopod, muton, berserker, faceless, archon, gatekeeper, viper, and elite lancer. Weird that they don't have andromedons. Even weirder still, that they still have heavy mechs and sectopods available when the control center died. But assault the alien fortress, that is going to have to wait until next episode, because I'm gonna take a little break. But next episode, we're gonna head into what is probably the final mission in XCOM 2 and the final episode of our XCOM 2 Commander playthrough. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to like it right here, and I hope to see you all in the final episode of our XCOM 2 Commander playthrough. Thank you guys enormously for watching, and see you next time. Goodbye.